It's like any other morning. You make some coffee, get the newspaper, and sit down and read the front page. Microbial life found on Europa. What's Europa? You read the article and realize that Europa is one of Jupiter's moons. All of a sudden, you feel goosebumps on your neck. This is no longer like any other morning. The world is not going to be the same, you say. It's a triumph of science and technology. In front of your eyes, you say. Finally, we are certain that life is abundant in our universe, you say. Very exciting. What good news, you say. Well, no, not really. Not good news at all. It's really, really bad news. Why? Why is it bad news? It's not like they can kill us from all the way over there, two planets away. Why is it bad news? To really get scared of this news, you need to understand the great filter. We humans don't want to be alone in the universe. It's scary to think that we are the only conscious sentient beings out there. So in 1984, some smart people decided to set up a project called SETI to search for life outside our planet. Since then, SETI has been listening. Not once, mind you, not once have they found anything apart from random farmers in rural America claiming to have been probed deeply by aliens. Our known universe is huge. But let's just ignore everything and focus on our galaxy called the Milky Way. The Milky Way is 100,000 light years across, made of around 100 billion stars. Many of those stars have planets, and a lot of planets are like the Earth. Lots of places for life to evolve. Look, life goes where it can. Deep in the oceans of the world, there are places where no sunlight goes, and the only source of energy is hot water coming out of geothermal vents. And life grows there. Life fills all niche on a long enough timeline. And thus, using the same reason, if life could, it would fill the galaxy. And since our galaxy is 12 billion years old, there is so much time to expand. The point is that we should have seen something out there, or someone should have visited us by now. So where is everyone then? Why is our galaxy not full of life? This is a paradox. Reason says one thing and reality sways the other way. This is called the Fermi Paradox, or the Great Silence, and it has to be explained, and explained it is with the Great Filter. Giving in to the demands for an answer to my doubt, the creator stood humble but strangely stout and claimed a certain inability to make sense of the probability that none of the planets in the galaxy hold any life worth talking about. How could that be? In the whole galaxy, we are the only ones asking this question. Is life so rare that no one's out there and we should leave this obsession? With a hand on my shoulder, the creator said, "You notice the harmony around us widespread, but go unnoticed all the failures and hardships fought in billions dead." "Well, tell me," I said then, "O Creator Supreme, what does it take to make the galaxy beam full of life from left to right and fore and aft? Please write me a draft of all the checks life needs to mark to fulfill this galactic dream." "Well, first you need a bright white star and a planet revolving not too far, but not too near. A thick atmosphere, some magnetic field lines, and water in the oceans are a very good sign. The second step is the inception of life in a chemical pool, which essentially means we need to find a self-replicating molecule that eats the surrounding chemical goo and then divides itself into two parts that resemble the whole and continue the cycle, with the only goal being survival until they themselves split. If some of the times they split, they end up changing a little bit, then the best of them might survive and eat the others' misfit. And slowly, by chance, during this brutal dance, the offspring produced get stronger and just pray that one day they might get a covering to help them live a bit longer. This covering is a protection that divides the world into sections, the ins and the outs and the surrounding whereabouts, and the machines within will fight the ones without and protect them from infections, but untold numbers will die and life shall make corrections. Winding and grinding, they'll chance upon a binding, assembling them together in one big balloon, sliding along in one stable cocoon, specializing themselves into different platoons that come together to form multicellular life. Now see, we have animals roaming free, adapting and reacting to environments beastly, but now comes the crucial checkmark. Intelligence is the next landmark, the tool's using ability, using stones to make a spark, starting a fire to kill the dark, and using its cooking utility, a hint of courage to embark on a journey to make their glorious mark to the limits of their capability. Mix in a dash of sociability, add in a bit of flexibility, a desire to change to climate stark. From thence might arise a cradle of civilization, a mighty force, a strong foundation, and spread across the planet at large, and gathering knowledge be the prime fixation. But this moment is very perilous, as knowledge can allow untold destruction in the hands of those that lack realization that life is the biggest fluke of nature. So is this the step where humans lie? Yes, the creator solemnly replied, and let's pray that you take the skies to spread out into the ocean of stars and resolve to flourish wide and far. And one fine moment in time, the galaxy shall come alive, and in that moment, my troubled butterfly, remember me in your written memoirs. So, 7 is the number of steps to a galactic civilization. But since our galaxy doesn't have a galactic civilization, one of these 7 steps must be hard to cross. That step works as a filter that doesn't let civilizations pass through. This filter is named as the Great Filter. We know that it's not step 1 because there are billions of planets ripe for the taking. So we hope it's one of the other ones behind us. We hope that it's not in front of us or we are doomed. We have always assumed that step 2, the inception of life, must be the great filter because this one-time event has always eluded explanation. We haven't been able to replicate it in the labs yet. But if tomorrow we find out that Europa has microbial life, it would mean that steps 2 and 3 are also very easy because they happen twice in our solar system itself, which means the great filter is either step 4, 5, 6 or 7, which means the chances that it's either 6 or 7 just got raised very significantly, which means the filter might just lie in front of us and we are all doomed to die on this one planet. That's scary, of course. Also scary is the fact that there are approximately 3,750 active nuclear warheads ready to fire in the world today.